those are the many questions that we are seeking answers to. Naveen Nair, a correspondent who got us that special report, joining us from Thiruvananthapuram. Naveen, what is this? This is lopsided allocation of quotas, isn't it? Al Hind getting 1,700 seats against all the other travel agencies put together, getting just 155.
Absolutely right, Karma. This is big money at play. Now, this document which I have with me is a writ petition which was filed at the Kerala High Court by three people, C. Mohammed Bashir of Palakkad, E. Abdul Rahim of Kollam, and one Mahin Muhammad Kannu of Trivandrum. And all these three people, they belong to three different agents, let me tell you, and they are small-time agents. So the complaint is that they have been sidelined. This is the tip of the iceberg. Now, if I can tell you the basic complaint, 10,000 is the quota which is given for private operators in Kerala. That's what we have seen. The majority of them, majority of the small-time agents across Kerala and majority of them in North Kerala telling me that between 2004 and 2008, Al Hind, agents called Al Hind and agents who are close to Al Hind have held sway, which means they have used up majority of them. And they, let me tell you, it's a huge lobby. It's a huge lobby which is at work. And they are also telling me that they have the blessings of E. Ahmed, who was the External Affairs Minister between 2004 and 2008. Now, let me tell you one more thing. In government quota, it's open lots. The quotas are decided by open lots. But here, there are no lots. Whoever has money, whoever has influence, whoever has power takes the huge chunk. This is the basic problem. More than 50,000 rupees is the difference of the ticket between a government ticket and a private ticket. So you have the story, you know where the big money is. And that's exactly what's been happening between 2004 and 2008. Karma.
All right, Naveen, certainly an investigation over there that the Ministry of External Affairs needs to look into. But there in Kerala, just how are travel agents, I mean, for the last 5 years, the ones that have been deprived of a quota, how are they saying they've really been affected?
Suhasini, there are a lot of travel agents who have taken money from people and then they have to give them back, small-time agents, because they have been promised quota and at the last moment they find out they don't have the quota and they get stranded. So that is the crux of the problem. Majority of the small-time travel agents have been promised quota. They have not been given quota because Al Hind and their partners take it away. So, and many of them will have to go to the general quota. Because of this, many of them have to go to general quota, which is decided by open lots. So yeah, that is the basic problem here.
Right, absolutely. Naveen Nair, thanks so much for joining us. Naveen, really making that point that it isn't just playing with public money over here. We're really talking about the hopes and aspirations of millions who want to go on Hajj. Now, we did speak to the man who's at the center of the controversy, E. Ahmed himself. He is now the Minister of State for Railways, but he was the Minister of State for External Affairs in charge of Hajj allocations. He rejected all allegations of favoritism,
but admitted that he may have favoured Al Hind out of discretionary allowance. The question really, how could the minister's allowance stretch to a whopping 1,700 pilgrims?
You know, Hajj quota is two. One is Hajj quota which has to be distributed through the Hajj committees. That will be on the basis of the Muslim population, and there is clear-cut numbers for every stage. Uttar Pradesh is the highest, and they have been giving highest. Many people have branches also, but this is the one company. And taking into account of their past performance, right, they may have got that quota. One son is there in Muscat, he's a CEO of two companies. And the son is in America, he's also a German SAP senior consultant. They are not here in India. And my daughter is a doctor who is the assistant professor and director of the Medical College of Dubai. My son-in-law is an eminent nephrologist in Dubai. Nobody there. Which is the family? Whoever wants to anger, let them anger. I don't mind. But ever since I took over this, because I have done something. I did not allow these dirty things going on in the Hajj committee and the office here and there. I did not. It is only because of my relationship, my work, my effort, this has been raised from 72,000 to 1,23,000. Is it wrong I have done?